Right, so here we are. So in this video we're going to mould up this fossil. This fossil is apparently around 500 million years old, and it's of the ammonite variety, and I picked that up a while back, and I'd like to replicate these and cast them in concrete, or maybe other materials, but primarily concrete. So yeah, we'll get started, and we're going to latex this fossil. We're going to make a latex mould. And so first of all, we want to prepare the object, and in this case obviously it's a fossil, for moulding. So I've already put a base around the edge of the fossil, which I don't know if you can see there. It's a little bit of plaster seam just to seal in the bottom of edges and kind of tidy it up and give it something to rest on when the casts are done. I'm going to have to put in a short seam along the side, so that's going to be the hardest part of moulding this. But anyway, like I say, I put the clay base in, just run some clay around the edge and squeeze that in and run it all around the fossil, and I stippled it with a paintbrush also, just to kind of blend it in with the rock. And so I'll give it some kind of texture, and just to seal it in. So yeah, the next step is to put the seam on. So what I'm going to do here, I'm actually going to use some of the plaster seam as well, just to hold my seam. I'm going to cut up the front cover of this magazine, and also use a profile gauge to help us out with following the profile of this part of the fossil. Right, so first off then, let's measure where we're going to put this seam and get the profile. So I think there will be good. So just push that in. Use your fingers. I'm not actually getting right down to the bottom, so I'll have to adjust that. So there we are, we've got our shape there. I'm now going to put this onto the magazine, and I'll draw that out onto the magazine with a pen. I'll just move that out of the way so you can see what I'm doing. So there we are. Now I'm going to cut this template out with a sharp knife. And that should fit where we measured the profile. So I'm going to back this up with a bit of plaster seam behind the seam, and then we'll stick it in place with the latex. So I've got the plaster seam clay here, and I'm just going to stick the seam roughly in place. I think I'll cut the bottom of that. So here it goes. I'm just going to put a bit of tape over where those two seams meet, or seam templates. Just check if everything's relatively flat. And I'm also going to apply some PVA glue, PVA wood glue, to the seam to help the seam template not stick to the latex, or so we can peel it apart easier. So here we go with the glue. Applied that, we'll wait for the PVA glue to dry before applying the coats of latex. Right, now I'm gonna dab some latex around where the seam meets the fossil. I think really it might be better to use some plastic as this seam template, so I should probably use plastic the next time I do one of these. Anyway, here it goes. I'm just going to glue that in with the latex. Alright, so we'll let that dry and we'll come back and continue building up some layers. Right, so that coat of latex is set. I'm going to take the clay off from the other side, and we're going to PVA the other side of the seam template. So I'll just get the clay off first of all. Right, so I've taken the clay away, and now I'm just going to put a layer of PVA on this side of the seam, the reverse side of the seam. Let that dry, and then we'll just coat the whole sculpture with latex. Right, okay, we'll let that dry and then we'll start putting the latex layers over the top of the fossil and the seam. Right, so now we'll coat the other side of the fossil, of the seam, I should say, and we'll start layering up layers of latex on the fossil too. Right, so there we are, then I stippled on the first coat, I shall stipple on the second coat, and then we'll put, in total, 30 layers of latex over this fossil. Right, so here goes with the final layer of latex, so this is the 30th coat. And once we've applied this coat, we'll let it dry and set, and then we'll put a fiberglass mother mold over the top of the latex to hold it in place. So that'll be a multi-piece fiberglass mold. I've been practicing on my fiberglass molds now, so I know what I'm doing now. So I'll do another video of making up the mother mold, and another separate video casting the fossil with concrete, and then perhaps another video creating some paint effects for the concrete casted fossils. Right, so I've got a fan going to help dry the latex. during the molding process here, I use some of this fiber here, which is a good tip from the folks at DIYmolds.com. So thank you for that, for everybody who gave that advice. And I think that's about it. So yeah, the fibers, you can soak them in latex and then apply it to the mold. I tend to put a layer of latex down, then soak the fibers, and then stick it on top, and then work it in with the paintbrush or the handle with the handle of the paintbrush. So we'll let that set, and I'll do another video after this one, making the fibreglass mold, and like I say, casting and paint jobs.
So here's the final part of actually casting up our ammonite fossil, and these video clips have been taken from some other videos, obviously casting up other bits and pieces and the ammonite fossil. So as always, mix up the concrete to the appropriate mixture. which you can find out at a mix at the concrete on the channel. And we're just moistening the moulds there with some soapy water, which will help guide the concrete into the mould and tap out any air. And we've put this on the vibrating table also to tap out any air, unwanted air. And now, after it's cured, we're now demolding the ammonite fossil from the mould. So this one came out very nice indeed. So put the recipe up for the concrete on this video also, which you would have already seen come up on the screen. And now we're just cleaning up the fossil, taking any seam marks away. And there we are, one concrete casted ammonite fossil. So this is the last part in this fossil series with making the mould and casting. So there it is, alongside some other concrete pieces which are made during that casting batch. Also, if you want to back up your moulds, it might be an idea to make a master. Sorry, if you want to back up your casts, make a master cast by pouring in plaster of Paris to make your master cast, so when your moulds run out, you can, or wear out, I should say, you can make another copy from your master cast made from plaster. But you can make your master cast from anything. And also, if you're into making plaster casts, you can just make a plaster cast for fun. So there we are, the ammonite fossil, casted up and ready to do with whatever we want to do with it. Perhaps I'll do a paint job on this one. Perhaps I'll do a paint job on the concrete one also. Or just leave the concrete one natural. Since this video, I made quite a few concrete casts of the fossil, so they'll probably pop up in future videos on the channel. So anyway, there we are. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video, and see you soon. Over and out for now.